Alejandro Cruces Camberos is a native Tijuanense whose father, Manuel Cruces Cuellar, was the original producer of our show, Tijuana Window to the South.
Right, right.
Wow. Exactly. Yes. And this was in 1970.
Yes.
Wow. Yes. And you also come from a long line of television of directors, actors, performers, folkloric dancers.
Right.
I mean,
on both sides of my family, yeah.
Talk about art. And you're also one of a person who continues to promote art.
Correct.
From the region.
Yes, yes. We're very involved in attending and supporting many events and concerts and performances. And so my brother and I, we're always carrying our camera, and,
yes,
and we appear in many events, and we're recording and capturing the moments, and we look around and we don't see anybody else doing it. So we're collecting a very important collection of historical events and
yes,
concerts and performances that we'll never perform again, and,
wow,
and we have them on video.
Well, welcome to our show.
Thank
this
you.
Is exactly what we're talking about how diverse Baja is, how diverse everything is. And now that we're back,
right,
with now Baja Window to the South,
uh-huh,
how does that impact you, or what does that memories create?
Well,
you?
First of all, I'm very excited. I'm very excited to see this program and this project. It's working great, and it brings me back to when I was still a boy, and my dad he used to take us to the studio,
yes,
and we were watching all the huge cameras, and it took two people to push him back and forth. And he was the studio director, so from the control room, he used to,
yes,
give all the indications and everything. It was very exciting, very, very exciting to see how they performed the whole program. Yeah.
Wow.
Alejandro, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank
so you are an archivist of culture and the arts in Tijuana.
Correct.
Are these archives digital? Do you have some from film? How far back do these archives go, sir?
They're in video. Some of them go back to beta format.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, we've been doing it in video, and so we have in hard disks.
Mm-hmm.
And we have concerts that the members, they split or whatever, and performances that will never happen again, and we kept them on video. We have
how important to keep all of that for,
yes,
the memories, because Tijuana's got a very rich history.
Correct.
And it just keeps getting richer and richer every day with all the culture happening.
Correct, yes.
And
yes,
what are some of the things that you have seen of the evolution of art?
Well, it's always expanding, and since the 70s and even 60s, Tijuana has always been like the birthplace of many good artists that they start local and then they become international. One of them that we know is Carlos Santana. He used to rehearse here and then he became an international. So it's very exciting to see the art, how it's been evolving and evolution.
And you are doing that by filming it, by sharing it,
right,
you and your family, you guys have been, this is who we are, let's share it with the world.
Right.
And then
right,
we also get great feedback.
Right, right.
And
exactly,
more artists and more people feel like this is something that I can do.
Yes.
And just receiving the love from the community, that means a lot.
Yeah, and even the artists, that they're constantly, thanking us, saying, wow, this is great. We never imagined that somebody would record our performance.
Yes.
So they're very grateful for that also.
Well, thank you so much for coming to our show. Thank you so
thank
much
you.
For what you do.
Thank you.
Thank you for promoting the arts.
Yes.
And then thank your father.
Yes.
Oh my God.
With that Alejandro's father, we probably wouldn't be here today. I want to say your family and that is gratitude, as well as you, Alejandro, for being such a supporter of the arts in Tijuana and keeping track of all of this for history. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.